The HVZ reaction is a reaction for alpha bromination of a carboxylic acid. The reason we use these reagents and the reason why this is different from normal bromination of a ketone is because we must protect the acid as an acyl bromide first. Otherwise, bromination will not occur. And we also have to wait till the very end to add water or we'll decompose our protected carboxylic acid first. So let's look at the mechanism of the HVZ reaction. And so we start with our carboxylic acid in the presence of our active reagent, PBr3. And we're going to highlight one of the bonds here. Okay, mechanistically, we can simplify things by taking a lone pair on the oxygen, forming a double bond, and then opening this double bond to grab and attack nucleophilically the phosphorus, kicking off a bromine. Okay, so this is an SN2 type reaction here. When we do that, let's look at what we get. We form a great leaving group, okay, an OPBr2, and we have a protonated carbonyl at this point. And so at this point, we can say, all right, well, we've got a bromine floating around, a Br- that we just formed, and we can attack this activated electrophilic center. We've protonated the carbonyl, and so it's active now for nucleophilic attack. So we attack there and kick up the double bond as a lone pair on the oxygen. So what do we have now? Well, we've still got this good leaving group up here, OPBr2, and now we've also got an OH and a bromine. So this ends up as a tetrahedral intermediate, and so we can highlight this as being important intermediate for the forward reaction. And then we eliminate a leaving group. The better leaving group is here versus the bromine, and if we eliminate the bromine, nothing happens. This is somewhat reversible at this point. Hey, we should point that out, that we're at this point reversible. And so if we kick off the bromine, nothing happens. So what we're going to do is, in the scenario that gets us closer to the product, we're going to kick off the OPBr2, and let's look at what we're left with. So we end up with, again, a protonated carbonyl and then a bromine. So we've essentially protected our carboxylic acid as an acyl bromide. At this point, we want to tautomerize using some base from solution, not water, however, and make this an enol. So when we do this, we form the enol from the protonated ketone, essentially acidic conditions here. And then remember, we've still got some bromine floating around, molecular bromine, and so we can collapse back to the carbonyl, open the enol, and perform our alpha bromination, very similar to the mechanism we already know for ketone alpha brominations. And again, we have this protonated carbonyl here, and now we've alpha brominated. So at this point, we are absolutely okay to add water in step two of our line reaction. And so when we do that, we start to decompose the acyl bromide. So we attack the activated protonated ketone at the electrophilic site, kick up this double bond to a lone pair, and form our tetrahedral intermediate again. There's our alcohol we've just attacked with water. And highlight one of those bonds to oxygen here as we move forward to be precise with our mechanism, because we have to form a geminal diol tetrahedral intermediate to proceed with our mechanism. Okay, and so here is our pseudo geminal diol. I know we're brominated here, but two alcohols on the same oxygen or on the same carbon, geminal diol. And then we're free to move forward with our mechanism, collapsing one lone pair to a double bond, kick off the good leaving group, what do we have? We have a protonated alcohol or protonated ketone there, or carboxylic acid carbonyl. We've got our carboxylic acid back, and to be precise with our mechanism, we then say, okay, well, highlight this bond. We've still got water as our solvent, and so it can collect that acidic proton, and we've successfully alpha brominated and reformed our alpha bromo carboxylic acid product, and we are done. Although I will point out that this decomposition of the bromogeminal diol is an irreversible step, which is why the reaction goes to completion.